With the rise of trends, web design, various libraries and frameworks, one of the prominent questions that really evolves around the trends in the web development technology that what should you really design, what should really implement the logic or the function in such a way that you really get most user interaction. And in today's video, we are just going to really talk about whether CSS animation are really useful or not. In this today's video, we are just going to really deep down in the various topic on the other edge, like on which cases whether the CSS animation is really useful and which case whether you should really try to avoid using it in a much more farther way. So what is CSS animation? Number one, well, if you are really well versed with the idea of developing in apps in CSS, then you really know that there are thousands of ways of permutations and combination where you can animate and the things and to really just kind of make the web really look interactive in it. And the purpose of really using the CSS animation is just to make the website much more interactive, much more user engaging, and to really make the website just look a bit little nicer. But should you really try to really use CSS animation in every other case? In simple case, no. And in general, it depends. But I just don't want to really just kind of really just say it like it depends whether you want to use it or not. But I really want to rather deep down into the details about how it's really beneficial, or how should is it really useful, or is it really whether you should really use it or not. So first of all, we have really discussed about what is the purpose of to really using the CSS animation, whether it's really to use much, whether it's really you to increase the user engagement and all that kind of stuff. But personally, what my opinion are, whether on the site which I really tend to go on and try to visit, which really generally use the CSS animation, I really find myself to really kind of more engaged to it, and just kind of really, I really enjoy really surfing the site to some or the other extent. But the CSS animation can really make or break your website, or and to really kind of break your user experience. So in which case should you really avoid or really avoid the use of CSS animation itself? Well, there are a lot of things out there. Suppose it depends upon the categorization whether upon here. If you really want to use the CSS animation or not, it generally depends upon what type of site are you really making out. Is it something which is really just kind of like people will not really use it often? It's really eventually people will just look for one or twice, then it's okay. If people are really just coming to your site and it has a various crazy amount of animations out there, people will really get an eye fatigue of watching all that kind of stuff. So if you have really worked with the CSS out itself, there is a library called Animate on Scroll. Suppose your site is really like any other site, like Facebook, Twitter, Tinder, or any banking site itself, and it has in various steps it has the animation. Now imagine yourself that you have really just kind of really need an information in really early stage. Now if you are really scrolling that for one time, okay, yeah, it really looks good. But for the 2 or 3 and 4 or 5 times, if really it really it just makes us eye looks, it just makes us look too really bored and tired to some extent out there. So what I'm really trying to essentially look like is you have to really look up to the use cases where you actually really need to really look like. I have really seen bunch of cool projects out there where they have really used a crazy level of CSS animation to really just kind of depicting the motion graphics, and really that is a really at par high scale that even I myself I'm not able to do that. But for the normal people like you and me out there, we really don't need that much of animation itself, right? So now imagine your site. Now imagine if you are really building a site like Facebook, Netflix, or Amazon itself. It is generally more recommended to really kind of keep your site as non-animating as itself, because I myself really kind of we'll be able to get that result as fast as possible itself. Now, in which case the making an animation or to apply the animation or to implement any animating library makes really more sense to you? For example, if you are really making a site on your portfolio itself, which people are not really going to often check out, then in that case, CSS animation can really be helpful for you. If you are really making a site on event base, which is a temporary host event, generally all the event sites are really kind of just made for the temporary purpose for this and that period of amount of time itself. And generally what I have really seen, suppose like take this site for example, like for I live in Pune itself, so take this site, AWS Community Day Pune itself. It has a really cool bunch of animation on scroll library it has really used for itself. People will generally really just you will visit that site for more, not more than 2 or 3 times itself. If they really like it, they will buy that ticket and they will just book their seat and they will just relax. But if you are really building a social networking site, banking site, or which anything that really requires serious and fast retrieval of data, or anything just like this Tesla.com, which my favorite company itself, one of my favorite companies, another than mention less. So coming back to our point, if you are really building something which people are really going to visit a long time itself, and you don't want that crazy animation itself, you really want them to really just kind of really a fast result itself, then you should really avoid the animation itself. And if you are really building a fun, if you are really building an interactive purpose thing, if you are really building something like just I mentioned, like a job portfolio, event marketing page, or any event function displaying page, just like the AWS Community Day, which I have really mentioned out there, and to really list a product itself, which is not frequently changing on your site itself. Now imagine that one day Amazon decided that yeah, we are really going to implement the AWS library, that animate on scroll library. Now you are really habitual to really just kind of get through it and look that result as fast as possible. You don't care about the animation, you just want the result as fast as possible, and you should really look up to it. Now imagine if you are really scrolling up there for first time, it will look like wow, it is just kind of good. For second time, oh, why is it really going fast? I really want my result fast to go into it. And third time itself, you like it's stupid to use animation on such sites. So on the other hand, you should really be careful whether on which cases that you should you really need the animation itself, which case you should really avoid itself. So I have basically given you the two scenario itself, and the most important thing is like just rather making animation itself, you really lay out the design in the correct style and the correct font, the beautiful interactive images on the stock photography images like itself, I don't think you probably really need to use the animation itself. But it really depends on certain cases. I personally find myself, if some site has really an animating element, just like the animating button, or just like take this on example of the MongoDB site, they have something, or if you really go on to their site, they have really just on the upper right hand corner, they have something when you really move mouse around there, the squares really just kind of hover it. You check that out if you really want to, if you're really interested in that. The purpose of the animation is, like again I'm repeating itself, to really make much more people engaged to your site. But you should really be aware, you should really be concerned about what kind of animating you are doing, you know. So the animation that you do on the website can really make or break your site itself. People will generally appreciate you if you really do it in the right way. It can really increase your marketing sales, and at the day, the work that you do on your website, the more the people are gonna really spend the longer time on your website, generally really translates into the more money itself in the IT world, if you know what I'm really talking about. So this is, guys, I really want to say whether you should really use the CSS animation or not. But one thing I will at last, what I really suggest, like just be careful about whether you really want to use the CSS animation or not. Just try to be as simple as possible. Don't really kind of punch it around it, but it totally depends upon what kind of circumstances are you really using that. And one thing, whether you should really kind of use it or not, it depends upon various scenario itself, and it also depends upon what you really want to deliver the value to the customer itself. So if you want just a clarity about whether which type of animation should you do or which type of animation should you not follow, then consider the following the modern and the latest web design trends and technology. And also you can really take the reference out to the website which are really similar to you and which are really really generally just like exactly like you, and you can really just try to look up whether what type of animation they are using or not, what positive outcome is actually gonna coming out due to that animation itself. So you can really just try to really crack the code itself and really try to hack it into this. This was guys, I really want to just say whether you should really use a CSS animation or not. So till then, next time, stay subscribed to my channel. If you have any question, queries, comments, just please mention right now in the comment section. I'll be really happy to get back to you. So till then, stay subscribed to my channel because I'm really going to push so much lot of content about the React.js, JavaScript, CSS, and bunch of other tools. So till then, stay connected and have a nice day. Bye.